So, examples of a binary relation would be like equals, so x equals y, more than, x is more than y, friends, is person A friends with person B, or is person A related to person B, or stronger than. A is stronger than B, and these are different types of relations. And really, a relation in the abstract, we write it as X, R, Y, where R stands for the relation between X and Y. And we can think of this as really being like a function. Like in normal maths, we might have a function of two variables, x and y, and it would output a number, maybe z. But here, what we're outputting is going to be either true or false. And they're the only two possible values that it can output, which is why it's called binary. So either x is equal to y, either that's true, or it's false. And this is either true or false. And the same for this, true, false. So another example of a binary relation would be implies. Does X imply Y? Now that's either true or false. And I'm sure you can think up different examples of binary relations. Anything where it's either true or false, and you give it two variables. So greater than or equals to is another one. Bigger than. A bigger than. Brighter than. Okay, and so then the question is, what do these things mean? So symmetric just means that if x is related to y, then y is related to x. So for example, if x is related to y, if person x if is related to y, then we know it's true the other way around. Y is related. And so relations like equals, that's symmetric. Related, probably friends, that should be symmetric. If Alice is friends with Bob, then hopefully it'll be the true the other way around as well, and Bob will be friends with Alice. So So, can we think of some relations which are not symmetric? Those are all symmetric. For instance, stronger than. A is stronger than B is not symmetric because it does not imply that B is stronger than A. In fact, we know it's not true. So we can say stronger than is not symmetric, and greater than is not symmetric. A greater than B does not imply that B is greater than A. So that's symmetric. And now let's talk about reflexive. And reflexive just means that X is related to itself, so that this is always true. So, thinking about the relations we've seen before, which ones? So, stronger than. Is not reflexive because X is not stronger than X. Also, X is not bigger than X. So these are examples where it's not reflexive. Is always equal to itself, so this is reflexive, X is always related to X is, so Bob is going to be related to himself. Related to is reflexive. But X is greater than or equal to X is reflexive. But X is greater than X. That's not true, that's false. So, greater than is not reflexive. So, the last one transitive. A good example for transitive is stronger than. If A is stronger than, I'll just write ST for stronger than. If A is stronger than B and B is stronger than C, that means A is stronger than C. So stronger than is reflexive, is transitive. If A equals B and B equals C, then A equals C. So equals is transitive, and I'm trying to think of an example which isn't transitive. So we want something. A implies B, and B implies C. Then A implies C. Well, actually, this isn't necessarily true. Oh, yeah, it is true. So, I'm going to have to go back to the drawing board on that. Can you give some examples of a relation that is not transitive? Relation that is not transitive.